The ocean around Antarctica has some of the biggest storms in the world. I'm in a ship crossing 25 to 30 foot waves, the winds blowing 100 miles per hour. And I discovered I get very seasick. But when I saw land, I was amazed at the towering cliffs of ice, the icebergs, glaciers, and suddenly I knew I wanted to become a polar scientist.
Welcome to Wavelengths, where we talk about our planet with experts from Scripps Institution of Oceanography, covering everything from the deep sea to the edge of the atmosphere. I'm Kate Furby, a marine biologist and journalist. I got my PhD here a few years ago, and now I'm back, learning more about what's happening at Scripps.
Okay, we're here today with Allison Cusick. She is a PhD student and Antarctic plankton biologist. I am so excited for today.
Me too.
Tiny things are my favorite.
Mine too.
What are we gonna do?
Today we're gonna go to the end of the pier and take a phytoplankton sample.
Perfect. Yes. Seems like really great weather for that.
It's possibly the stormiest day in San Diego.
All right, let's go do it.
Okay.
So how did you get interested in science in the first place?
I would say I've always been interested in the natural world, and when you know you try to figure out what you're going to be when you grow up, I think traveling really appealed to me, and I thought of all the humans that traveled the most would be astronauts, because they go to the moon. So I looked up what astronauts got their undergraduate degrees in, and it was a lot of science. So when I went to university, I was like, okay, I'll major in biology and geology and kind of set on the path of becoming a scientist. Make sure everything's secured.
This is like the most extreme plankton sample.
I know, this is very epic. Normally we'd be sampling off a boat.
Okay, so now we have like a plankton smoothie.
Yeah, so this is a plankton smoothie. I mean, you want to drink it? It's salt water. So if you look inside, you can convince yourself maybe you see something floating, but yeah. We can go take a look under the microscopes in the lab so we can see the true magic that's hiding in this sample.
Okay, so now we have this jar of concentrated seawater. How big are the little guys in here?
The phytoplankton in that jar will range a little smaller to a little bit bigger than the width of a human hair.
Wow, okay. Tiny.
Tiny.
All right, while you're setting this up, why are we looking at plankton?
Phytoplankton are basically the engines of life. So they are responsible for producing over half of Earth's oxygen.
Wow, so, no big deal.
Yeah, no big deal. So every other breath we take, we can thank phytoplankton.
Thank you.
They're also using carbon dioxide and sunlight to make energy. So every animal in the ocean relies on phytoplankton to produce that first source of organic carbon.
Cool, it's like the foundation of the ecosystem.
Yes, exactly.
So like looking at this to the naked eye, I'll be honest, it looks like a dud. I don't see with my eye anything on there.
Yeah, no, that's why I love saying that they're invisible forest, because you really can't see anything. And so a lot of people don't think the ocean can have that much going on in it unless you see a big whale or a seal, but really the magic is happening at the microscopic level. So you wanna take a look?
Ooh, wow, all right. There's so many little things moving around in here. What am I looking at?
So those are phytoplankton. And basically, phytoplankton are the Greek words for phyto, and plankton means plant drifter.
Ooh.
So it's a plant-like organism that's single cell, and they just drift around using photosynthesizing, using sunlight and carbon dioxide to make energy.
Amazing.
So I've saved these. They came all the way from Antarctica. I'm just gonna see what these guys look like.
Cool, and that's what you usually study, right?
Yeah, I am a polar phytoplankton specialist, so my study region is in Antarctica.
This is amazing. It's incredible what you can see in one drop of seawater.
Oh yeah.
So in Antarctica, how are the plankton interacting with the other organisms?
The animals that live down there are, you know, our favorite penguin. We have whales, seals,
all of them rely on eating food from the sea. And they mostly rely on eating a certain type of food called a krill, an Antarctic krill. It looks like a little shrimp. And those shrimp actually eat the phytoplankton.
I assume that if anything goes wrong with the plankton, it moves up the web, right? Like anything that happens at the foundation of this ecosystem could have major impacts as we move up.
So one of the topics I'm researching is looking at if, you know, the glaciers in Antarctica are melting, they're putting a lot of fresh water into the marine ecosystem, which is saltwater environment, that might shift the types of phytoplankton that we see, and then that might shift what is available for the different species that need to exist down there that are used to one way of living. Your entire, what you've specialized to eat has suddenly changed.
I wish more people knew about this.
Yeah, I wish so too.
And that's another thing you're working on, right? Like yeah. Trying to get the word out?
Yeah, at least every year we have about 1,000 people participating in a project that I run called Fjord Phyto. And we designed this effort where we can give simple oceanographic instruments to the tour ships, and then we train staff that work on those ships to facilitate the project when travelers come and go.
This is a CTD, which stands for conductivity, temperature, and depth. And this little sensor measures chlorophyll.
So they can get their hands wet, they can help collect samples, they can help collect data, and then every year we get about 100 sampling events back, and then we put together the full story of what's happening, kind of like over space and time.
Wow. And that helps you get way more data than you would if it was just you, Allison, having to go down and collect the water yourself.
Yeah, exactly. So if we can see what's happening each season, can we predict how things might change for the future, get a sense of the ecosystem.
Amazing. Thank you so much for taking the time to show us this tiny, sparkling world.